the number of robberies, particularly cash, which is happening later.
Unknown thugs armed with AK-47 assault rifles on the evening of January 24th, 2023, stormed the home of a businessman in Apac municipality, shot his son in the leg, and robbed an unspecified amount of money.
Some two border guys came following me from behind, and one person came and opened fire and hit this very spot where you can see. This is where the bullet hit.
In a similar manner, two armed thugs moving on a motorcycle trailed Fred Twine, a bank agent, from his place of work on Obote Avenue and caught up with him at his home at Tarita Comfort Lodge on Aduku Road and robbed him of over 100 million shillings.
We really have to be very careful. We have been carrying large sums of money, like now over 10 million shillings, and you're moving from one place to another. I will request that we have an armed guard.
Twine says the thugs arrived and put him at gunpoint just as he parked at his place.
So he speak to me in Kiswahili and told me that if you don't open the door, I'm going to kill you.
It costs you nothing, even if you were to go to police and then you hire one police escort or two, particularly for cars which is involving over 20 million. You need two. And then you pay them 20,000. You will have saved all your money.
Deo Obura, the regional police commander, says two people are arrested to help with an investigation into the robbery. However, he has asked residents to remain vigilant and cautious.
We managed to pick some two suspects to help us follow up the leads. And I think that is the step we've taken, and our officers are still on the ground. We believe with the cooperation of the community, we shall make a breakthrough and probably put an end to this new vice.
Bosco Ogwang Edola, the director of Uganda National Chamber of Commerce for the Northern Region, says they are concerned over the continuous robberies. He has advised the business community to be very cautious as they move large sums of money.
We have to be cautious about ourselves in our business premises, where you see that some movement is not the normal one in where you are. You alert the security people. Let us be security conscious. Let us not live our lives just the way it's ordinarily done. Because you remember in the past what happened, around 2012 what happened. So many people lost their lives because of money.
Meanwhile, police in Kole are hunting for five brothers who ganged up and beat their uncle to death over a land dispute.
I really condemn that sort of action and brutality. Senseless killing of innocent people is not allowed and it should not continue.
Police are also investigating a case where relatives of the deceased carried out a reprisal attack, destroying the homes of the suspects.
They were struggling over a property because this Ugalaberi married a second wife, and the first wife was not happy with the way her husband was handling the property, which actually she thought belonged to her and the children.
Walter Omara, 36, was attacked by his nephews while digging near a wetland and beaten to death. The incident happened at Te Opok Cell in Barongin Parish, a little sub-county, at around 8 a.m.
Because what has caused this moral degradation is the issue of the breakdown of families. The whole families are broken down. Children are no longer listening to parents. The parents are no longer bringing their children in the cultural way.
The regional police commander, Deo Obura, says suspected killers are on the run, but police are following up on the matter. The regional police commander says they have challenges with some clan leaders who try to handle capital cases. He has condemned acts of vengeance.
The culture that I think people have grown up with here is a culture of revenge, which actually is not the right way to sort out matters.
David Adonyo, clan chief of Okiyamat, in charge of Te Opok Cell, says there was a land dispute between the deceased and his nephews that ended in the murder.
We have started engaging our lower clan leaders to have regular meetings on a monthly basis.
Story by Hudson Apunyo for the news.